facing my dad. We have two guests, okay? You can introduce yourself first.
I'm Donald Nicks. I'm the bass player. I played with Dennis when we played with Roy Ayers.
And introduce yourself.
And my name is John Pressley, and I'm the vocalist and the road manager that played with Dennis when he was with Roy Ayers. I met Dennis Davis in 94. I knew the band, you know, I knew how great he was, you know, they called him the Pocket Master, you know that's what he was called. He was a hell of a drummer, a great person. So when I came in the band, you know, and we kind of just got tight. I mean, from Dennis was like that. He would draw people to him, and he either liked you or he didn't like you.
Yeah.
You know, and I'm glad that he liked me, you know.
All right. What's the best memory of Dad and both as a musician and as a friend?
Well, I'll give you the funniest memory.
Okay.
Which we all kind of enjoyed. You know, Dennis, we would play a song called Night in Tunisia. This is a song by Dizzy Gillespie, one of the few jazz tunes, you know, straight ahead jazz tunes that we played with Roy. And there was a section of the tune where Dennis would have the stage to himself with the drum solo, then he'd do his scatting thing. That was kind of like a highlight of that tune. I think him and Roy had some words before we played the tune anyway, and they was exactly on the best terms at that point. And so when it comes to the part where Dennis told solo, Roy said, okay, everybody get off the stage. Just let's go back in the dressing room. We're at Ronnie Scott's in London. And the dressing room is right behind the stage. So we all get off the stage, and we hear Dennis doing his thing, and he's doing it, and he's doing it, and he's doing it, and doing it. And after a while, he stops. You know, we hear him stop, and he runs backstage. What are you doing? Come on back upstairs, hurry up! Roy just told us to kind of stay behind stage. He was kind of punishing him, kind of teasing / punishing him for getting on his bad side. So Dennis had to keep on doing his scatting, you know, longer than he usually does it. And it was just so funny, you know, the way he came running backstage.
What was your best memory as a friend and as a musician?
Dennis and I, when I came in the group, I used to like to try to dress sharp, you know. So that was our little battle thing, you know. Dennis, he would come in, he would be sharp. I come in, I'm sharp, you know. He'd look at me, he'd say, okay. I look at him, I said, okay, you know. And we did that for years. There's just so many things I can say as far as being a friend. Dennis, I used to be at his recording studio, you know, and we would always be working on something. Always working on something. You know, he never said what I was doing was wrong. He always gave me the encouragement to, yo man, I like that. I just need you to do a little more. You know, and that's the type of person Dennis was. You know, if you could do it, he would definitely push you. If you couldn't do it, he would definitely tell you.
He would definitely push you. You couldn't do it.
Yeah.
That's one
yeah.
thing I want to add too, that he very open to different things.
Yeah.
So, you know, so if you heard something that he liked, he'd try to encourage you.
Yeah.
If like, for instance, like you talk about the studio. And I remember an instant where I'm playing something that I thought was a mistake, but he liked it. Dennis liked it. It was cool. Do it again. I'm like, I forgot what I did. No, come on. I'll play the tip again. You just do it again, man. Just do it. I'll play it back, and then you play. Just do it again, man. You know, because he's just open like that, and that's kind of why he was so versatile.
Yeah.
What does Dennis Davis drumming mean to you?
Dennis had the art of drumming down to a T. You know, this is something that a lot of young drummers need to learn. It's one thing to have a lot of technique and to be able to bash away and do all kinds of crazy stuff. But there's an art to drumming, to be able to listen to what the rest of the band is doing, to be able to support the band, to be able to support a soloist, to make a soloist sound exciting. A lot of young guys nowadays don't have the art of it. art of drumming down. So it's real important, you know. And so Dennis is like an example of all of that. You know, his groove is so tight, and he just knew how to play enough behind soloist and how to play strong behind the band without overpowering them. So, that's what his drumming meant to me. He was an example of what drumming should be.
If he was still here, what would you tell him?
Well, we used to call Dennis Colonel McBragg, so there's not much I can tell him. We call him Colonel McBragg because, a funny instance though, you know, a lot of times we finish playing, and we would say, where's Dennis? Where's Dennis at? You're looking for Dennis. We just say, just look for a big circle of people. Dennis is in the middle. When I was with Stevie Wonder, when I was with David Bowie, when I was with George Benson, and he just have them mesmerized. So, you know, so I don't know what to say to Dennis, you know. I appreciate your friendship. I've learned a lot from you. I'm glad you were in my life.
I guess I would tell him that I wish that I had been around him a lot more than I was. When he used to call me and ask me to do a gig and I had something else to do, rather than making time to do it for him, you know, I went ahead and do what I had to do, but I should have took time and did what he asked me to do. He always wanted me to sing, always wanted me to come and sing, always. I mean, just always. John, come on, man. You know, always, you know. And always gave me that motivation to sing, you know. And I guess I was, yo, man, I miss you. I love you.
If you could play one song with Dennis again, which song would you want to
play? Levels of breaks and oh, man, you know, it would start and Dennis would be, you know, he would be on it, and he would take it all the way to, we used to call that, said that, once we got to that point, we said, the airplane is on the runway, and it's taking off, and Dennis would just, everybody would download them, everybody would just be playing their butts off, singing. It was, whew, that would be the song, and no drummer have ever played it like that.
Dennis kind of set the standard. For most of the drumming and the band, you know, but that particular tune, especially, was almost like a musical composition. It went to, like John said, went to a few different changes, you know, as far as you know, rhythm is concerned and stuff like that, and
breaks.
And Dennis kind of made that song.
Yeah, he did.
You don't think drummers are being composers, but that's a good example of drummers being a composer. Yeah. You know, you couldn't really play that song unless you played the rhythms the way Dennis played them.
Yeah.
So, that's a good song too. Thank you. No Stranger to Love.
No Stranger.
Yeah.
Can you give me any advice, something my dad would tell me?
Stay in school.
Wow. Of course I will do that.
Well, let me see. If you plan to, stay in school, first of all. But I saw in one of your videos that you were going to play guitar. So I think he would tell you, if you're going to play guitar, play it with all your heart.
Okay.
Play it, you know, don't half step on it, you know. Get into it, learn as much as you can on guitar. And play it with all your soul, and enjoy playing it.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, and if you don't enjoy playing guitar, don't play guitar.
That's true. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Play drums.
Really?
Yeah, really. Yeah. I really think. Yeah, I think. I'm sure your father would love to see all his kids play drums. You know, that's just him. You know, he would like everybody play the drum. But I do know that he would, whatever you choose to do, he would want you to do it to the fullest.
Okay.
Right. He don't want you to do anything that somebody else tell you to do. You know, You know, he would want you to do, if it's something that you really want to do, you know. He would want you to do it to the best. Okay?
So I want to yawn.
Okay?
That's all the questions today.
That's all the questions?